Hey, what's going on, everybody? Mark Medina here, Tom Marks there. Tom, we are here talking about the Valve Steam Link app.
Yes.
We've tested it extensively these past few days, and we have some thoughts.
Yeah, it's not quite what I was hoping for, but it's also still pretty cool.
Yeah.
It's definitely got problems here and there. Mm-hmm. It's a mixed bag for sure.
Yeah, so we're going to start with the pros here, which is the biggest pro. It actually works.
It does. Yeah. That is a very big pro. Yeah, it works shockingly well. Granted, IGN has very, very good internet.
Yeah.
So that could be part of this. I'm not, your mileage may vary, and it is a free app. You'll be able to test it out, and if it just doesn't work, you kind of haven't risked anything.
Yeah.
The biggest drawback of this is that you have to be on the same network.
Yeah.
My dream of like playing GTA on my phone while on the train to work is like, that's
not gonna happen.
That's not gonna happen.
It's also kind of scary because you're worried that that probably wouldn't work so well anyway.
Right, right.
So like when we say it works well, like it actually works well. We were playing games like Celeste.
Yeah.
And Borderlands and like almost no input lag.
Almost none,
which is
yeah.
amazing compared to things like PS Now that over the air, even on a wired connection, a little laggy.
Yeah, and the key here is, as long as your host PC is strong enough to run the game, as long as your internet is good, as long as the Ethernet is plugged into your host PC, streaming it to an iPad, like streaming Celeste to an iPad, it had like, for those kind of fine touch games like Celeste, you can notice like little bits, like it's not gonna be the perfect way to play, but it is 100% playable.
Yeah, and even better on the Apple TV.
Apple TV and Android TVs will have an app for them as well, and they do have internet or Ethernet. So when I was playing on an Apple TV with an Ethernet plugged in, it was essentially just like playing on the PC. Like it was, I could not tell at all because at that point you're basically playing LAN.
Right, exactly. All right, so let's talk about some of the cons we have here.
Yeah.
The biggest one for me was lack of controller support on iDevices.
Yeah, so the trickiest thing right now is that the Steam Link app has built-in support for a Steam controller. It's really, really easy to set up your Steam controller on your phone, on your TV, whatever it is. You just hook it up as a Bluetooth device and it's done. But the problem is iOS devices have extremely limited controller support otherwise.
Yeah.
You can actually hook up like a PlayStation 4 controller to any Android phone
just
right out the gate and it'll work and that's great, but that support doesn't happen on any Apple device, and so you have this
apparently
situation.
Most Apple-supported controllers, it doesn't support clickable sticks anyways, which would also be an issue for things like a first-person shooter. Same network as your PC is another thing we kind of already mentioned. Like, you have to be on the same network. So what it essentially does is you're choosing to not use your PC to go somewhere else in your house and play your PC on your phone. Because you can't. Like, if you're playing a Wii U and the kid's gonna, you know, don't use the TV anymore, we're gonna watch a soap opera or whatever, so then you take the pad somewhere else, it totally works fine. This is not the same case. Your computer is running the game, so nobody can touch it.
Nobody can touch the computer. That's the same exact problem as the Steam Link has. It's only gonna be used for certain people in certain cases, but again, since it is free, it's nice that the people that want access to those cases don't have to spend a bunch of money on this Steam Link box. Basically, the only thing the Steam Link box now gets you that an Apple TV wouldn't get you now with the app is USB ports for keyboards and mice and much, much better controller options.
And then the last thing I would mention, and I'm not sure if this was your experience, but the last con I have would be like installing a game from the device doesn't work super well. Like I would install like Borderlands 2 and the resolution was messed up, and so then it would just show me a white screen on my phone. And even here yesterday, we were trying to test it, and I kept having to go back to my computer to like turn things on and minimize stuff. And
that's another one of those problems that the Steam Link has kind of always had, and it's just sort of hard to solve, is it runs through big picture mode, and then it just streams your desktop. So if you wanted, you could just stream Google Chrome or Firefox or whatever you want. You can just stream your desktop on your phone or your PC through the Steam Link app. But as a result, since it's trying to find the game, it's doing all these weird window things, there's a lot of times where, like, sometimes the audio won't work for whatever reason. Sometimes it'll just be a black screen, but you'll only hear audio.
Yeah.
Like, there are just little edge cases like that that definitely have been a long issue of the Steam Link and aren't fixed here.
Exactly. Okay, so that's it for the Steam Link for the iOS and Android and Apple TV. It's all there. Of course, for everything else PC games, make sure you keep it right here on IGN.